Welcome to Let's Play NASCAR Dirt to Daytona Parts 8, yeah. So, one thing to note, I changed my livery again. I just made it just all black to lighten the shade of my number. There we go. Let's just keep it simple. It's like, I don't have a primary sponsor. It's kind of the default not, don't have a primary sponsor paint. Their livery, I don't fucking know. So anyway, it's time to upgrade this car since I have the money. And it may look like I can barely not afford this suspension upgrade, but with the trade-in of this, I actually can. So let's buy it. Very slight increase in front grip, but nice increase in rear grip and decrease in weight, so. So overall, I think it's a good buy over the choices I had. So there we go. And let's go on to their next race of the series at the Egan Speed Bowl. And this is actually a pretty important race. I'll get into details once qualifying is over. So qualifying, went very well. Qualified 7th, fuck yeah. Alright. Good stuff. I fucked with my gears a little bit qualifying, so it's actually a little too much. So I'm actually going to reduce the final gear one click. Just to prevent any engine damage, you know, blowing. So let's go to our heat race. So I said this race is kind of important because, well, one, it marks the beginning of the second half of the championship, and two, it is tied for the largest purse, money purse, in this series. So a good finish would be really good for momentum heading into the rest of the season, and my wallet. Be able to further upgrade this car pretty well. So that'd be nice to get a good run overall in the A feature here. So yeah. Of course, first we've got to make it out of the heat race, but I think I'll be able to finish in the top 5. I think. I don't know, I got 2 fast cars behind me. That's 1 too many. Well, now it's just 1 fast car behind me. Ooh, getting close to Anderson. Well, Henke's slowing down a little bit. So am I. Luckily, there's a lot of room on the inside of the track.
2 to go.
Alright, let's see if I can fucking clear this guy. There we go. Alright, clear around Henke. Actually, a good line around this track is more in the upper part. It's one of those tracks where the higher line is faster. Surprisingly. And I'm running about the same speed into the turns as I was with the fucking higher gear. Okay. Well then. But it looks like I'm going to easily transfer into the A main through the heat race. There we go. 4th place, not bad. Kato has to go through the fucking B feature. Alright. Here we go. Just gotta wait for Higgins and Friedman to finish. Apparently they're way the fuck behind. They are the back markers after all, so there we go. So made it through the heat race. Popped my jaw. Because that's what I do. And to the A feature, let's just get going with it. So since I finished 4th, I should be starting 7th place. Just look at people who transfer through the second heat. Damn, the 484 McBain, holy shit, he finished 3rd in the second heat. Alrighty. And the transfers through the B main, Kato, Rafter, and Diamond in the 471. Alright. So, time for 100 laps around this half mile Egan Speed Bowl. The A feature. Here we go. So, let's hope I can get a good finish in this race to propel my quest for 10th place final standings and money. Gotta get that money. So far, I'm being shuffled backwards very quickly. I'm already down to 9th, alright. Well, looks like McBain isn't that fast after all. He's falling back. Yoink. Kind of keeping a little too tight of a line here. Henke wants to get around me desperately. I need to start running a higher line so I can carry more speed down the straightaway. Out of the turn. Here comes Rafter. Careful. Don't want to slide. Get drifty on me, because that'll just scrub off some speed. Important speed. Okay, well, I've been shuffled back to 9th place. After 3 laps. Ooh. Looks like I might be able to get by Fazioli. Maybe. Oh, shit. Bad entry. Okay, kept it off the wall. Of course, running a higher groove here means I'm going to be really fucking scared about hitting the outside wall. Because that's the thing that would be easier to happen, you know. And here comes Inky. Get around me. Whoa. Make some contact.
That was a great lap.
He's fucking moving up, trying to clear me. I ain't having none of that shit. Oh my god. Oh, yeah, there we go. Got the wall, got the wall. Get off the wall. Get off the wall. Okay, I'm off the wall. And let's just move down on the inside of Henke. That somehow worked itself out pretty well. Alrighty. Whoa. Getting hooked on Henke. Got a real fucking fracas going on in front of me. For 6th, 7th, and 8th. Looks like I'm closing in a bit on Diamond, so I may be able to take 8th place here from him. Okay, maybe I should just run at the bottom part of the groove. Not the bottom of the track, but the bottom of the groove. And around Diamond I go. Of course, this place is easily the fastest track on the fucking weekly racing series. It's not called the Egan Speed Bowl for nothing, you know. Doesn't look like I'll be able to improve my position any further. Which is a disappointment, but 8th place is a good run, considering my current status of as far as my car upgrades and shit. Of course, this race is only 10 laps young, so anything can happen. Hopefully nothing bad. Ah. Got a little drift there. I'm running almost, like, equal lap times to Rafter. He's barely getting away from me. Maybe a 10th every couple laps. And Fazioli, who's directly ahead of him, isn't really pulling away from me much either. Actually closed the gap between me and Rafter a little bit that time, that lap. Keep it off the wall. They were about even that lap. I think we're too evenly matched here. I think he has a slight advantage over me, so. Also, he changed his lane now. He's running on the bottom part of the groove, so. And now he's pulling away. And he's catching back up to Fazioli for 7th or 6th place. Well, I have a 3-second gap on Hinkie, so that's good for me. Looks like they're catching up on to Peterson. Not sure if poor position or if Peterson's a back marker. Speaking of back marker, here comes Aldo Blatme. Leading the race, he gets a little squirrely because we made contact, but he's able to keep it under control. Notice this is also a pretty hard track for them to spin on. They actually have quite a bit of control. So it looks like Peterson's a back marker because that was definitely not for position. So Peterson is in 13th place. Now, how am I going to get around him? Apparently I'm not. I'm just going to go through him. That fucked up my front end. It's just body damage, but it still fucked me up. Ah, light contact with Peterson. Kato rear-ended me a bit. Okay, just slam on the brakes. Don't mind me. Whatever, Kato. Okay, now our next target is Brandt. Thank you for pushing me right into the wall, Kato. Fucking asshole. Hey, you're just gonna have to try again to get around me, bitch. Uh-oh. I think Kato's done. Yep. Kato's out. His car... whatever just happened, his car didn't like it. And, couldn't handle it. Alright. Well, that's another position for me. So... into 7th place I will go. There, goddamn. Took him a while to fucking pull off. And stop. There we go, into 7th I go. So now I pretty much established where I am as far as people running, so I guess just knock off some laps now. I have a 4-second advantage over Hinkie, and Fazioli is 2.4 ahead of me. Bring it up way wide, keep it off the wall, okay, we're good. Everything's fine. Everything is A-okay. I like how my current best lap in this race is 2/1000ths of a second slower than my best lap of the weekend so far. Not sure how that will translate into the replay. I think the replay shows like my best lap overall, including in this race, so yeah. If I manage to run a lap faster than that, just don't pay attention. Okay, so here's Truett. He'll have to put me a second lap down, maybe, or is he in like 5th place? Or something. Okay, he's definitely not the leader. Fifth place. Meanwhile, Rafter is in 5th place. He's probably in like 4th place. So it's kind of really weird and difficult being in kind of the middle of performance here, because not only do I have to deal with the leaders who are much faster than me getting around me, I also have to deal with the back markers that are much slower than me getting getting around them. You know, sometimes it just doesn't work out that way, or it just doesn't work out together. Because I'm trying to pass somebody, and somebody's trying to pass me, and it just turns into a big fuck shit. Speaking of, about to catch 484 of McBain, who definitely hasn't been able to follow up on his heat race performance. So let's just get around him real quick. So that's going to be 3 DNFs for Kato this season. It's been 6 races in our 6th fucking race. That poor scrub. He's fast, just not reliable. By that, by reliable, I mean his car isn't reliable. Who I'm assuming is the leader. Yeah, it's Al. Al is the leader. There we go. I go a second lap down. Peterson up ahead, so we're gonna have to deal with his slow ass in a couple laps. Five laps complete for me. Almost getting up into the wall. Alright, let's just swiftly get around Peterson. There we go. Just like that. Smooth and steady. That was a very easy overtake. I'm glad. Bringing it way down the track, don't mind me. Okay, here comes somebody behind me. I believe that's Anderson. Yes, it is. Looks like he's gonna try to get around the inside. Or not. Okay. It's gonna be really tough letting these guys go around the inside because they're gonna push me up to the fucking wall. I heard that contact. Okay, let's get around Brandt. Just as easily as Peterson. Chugga, 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 chugga. Chugging along, da-na-na, da-na. Yeah, I don't know. I might have to deal with Henke before the end of this race, judging by how little I'm pulling away. Al again already. Oh, hey, how you doing? You brought that upon yourself? Okay. I avoided him, and there's carnage behind me. Like I said, I'm gonna have to deal with Henke. Because he just gained fucking 2 seconds, possibly more on me. God damn it, Al. Just had to spin it. Oh, and he's out of the race. Oh, shit. Apparently that damaged his car that much. Alright. Well, that's another position for me. Off a completely unintentional wreck. Actually, yeah. So I guess that puts Finger in the lead. And he's gonna try to go down the inside, but I shut the door. Outside. Fucking rubbing him. Okay, Finger is not in the lead. Who the hell is the leader?
Okay,
it's not true,
Ed. Halfway, Mark.
Halfway through the race. Up to sixth place, so on pace to tie my best finish of the season. That's good. Maybe let Truett get by. Nope. Okay. And I'm sliding up into him. Use all of the racetrack. Alright. Well, now that those shenanigans are over, and I accidentally took somebody out, I'm really not good at racing cleanly, and it's not because I'm a dirty racer, it's because I'm very bad at judging things. Like placement of cars and shit. So yeah. So that means if one more person retires that's currently in front of me in the race, I'll get not only my best finish of the season, but my first top five of the season and LP and fuck. But I doubt that's gonna happen. But sixth place is still a good finish. Yeah, I'm tied for my best, and considering, you know, the payout for this race is gonna give me pretty good money. as well. And it's going to help me in the points. Good things all around coming from this. I just have to hope nothing goes bad wrong with my car. Because that has happened before. Remember Anoka? Yeah. Fucking power steering failure. And that other place where my brakes failed, but that was not an issue at all since I didn't use the brake at all. That track. What was that, Baxter? I think, I don't fucking know. It's been a couple weeks since I recorded part 7, okay? And here comes Rafter behind me to put me a lap down. Increasing my gap on Henke again. So that's good. Still can't believe this is going to be Kato's third DNF out of 6 races. Okay, well here comes Rafter and Anderson. Gonna let off the throttle, keep a tight line. Just so I don't cause any more mayhem. Just let those two by me. Let Henke gain a little time on me, but quickly eliminate that. Boy, here's Peterson. Just hurt on the inside of him. Take very deep entry. Okay, got around Peterson. Yuck. Looks like my next victim is going to be McBain. I see that orange car up there. You know what just hit me? You know who I haven't seen at all in this feature? Ginter. He didn't fucking make it, did he? I don't think he did. I'll have to hopefully remember that when I check the, event race results and shit. Like, overall. Hopefully I can remember that. I highly doubt I will. So, you know, in between that, I still have another, like, 36 laps to run. And the replay to record. So, yeah. Remembering that's not going to be an easy feat for me. Okay, let's get around McBain. Do the same strategy I did with Peterson. Just take it deep into the turn. Clear him, and there we go. I still kind of feel bad that I ruined Al's race. But shit happens. Yeah, I'm definitely not going to beat my best lap of the weekend and this race. I can't even get into the 22s anymore. Since, you know, this and this. Oh shit, Henke's closing the gap on me. It's 4 seconds now. So, still gonna have to deal with them still. So, the sixth place still is not certain. Have to deal with Henke's shit before this race is over, probably. closing in on Brandt. And caught up with Brandt. And trying to get around Brandt. There we go, cleared him. Alright. Next car for me to lap is fucking Diamond. That's gonna be fun, considering he's not running that much slower of a pace. I mean, it's taking me fucking 67 laps just to run a full lap faster than him. Watching that gap between me and Hickey, just very carefully. My index finger is so goddamn worn out right now because, been going 100% throttle for pretty much 99.5% of this race. So yeah. Not feeling very comfortable right now. All the way to the bottom of the track. Slide job on Diamond. Got a little... didn't quite clear him. Touched the front of his car a bit. And... there we go. I think I'm... yep, cleared of him now. Alright, there we go. So I've lapped the 8th place car. As I run in 6th. Here comes Truett. That's the wall. That was so close to the wall. At least I'm going to get a hell of a run off the turn. 95 miles per hour. I think that's the fastest I've run all race, like top speed. I'm finding a little bit of pace here in this line. Indeed I am. That's my first 23-0 in a long time. Finger. I think it's Finger. Yep, it's Finger. And he's gonna go down the inside. Force me up the track. Alright, he actually gave me quite a bit of room, so I applaud him for that. Oh fuck, Peterson! Gotta get off the throttle. Alright, let's get around Peterson. There we go. Somebody retired from the race. Who was it this time? I think it was Rafter. Somebody retired from the race. I'm in the top 5 now. I just noticed that. Alright, time to look at it. Yep, it was Rafter. I just zoomed by him. So, oh shit. Ugh. Got over the cushion. That was almost disastrous. So, looks like I'm gonna get my first top 5 finish at the LP. As long as nothing goes horribly wrong. Wonder what the fuck happened to Rafter. Because, he's out of the race. that's gonna give me more fucking inspiration to try to keep my gap on Hickey, so I can get my first top five finish and get my first payment from that one sponsor. Because, you know, they want me to finish in the top five, yeah. That's not an easy task. So, I said this is an important race to get a good finish on, and, so far, I'm on pace for a really damn good finish. Got just, 16 laps to go. Probably 15 for me. Although Hinkie is closing the gaps down to 3.2. So he's still catching me. Well, this has been a kind of an attrition-filled race. Three retirements so far. Ooh, this is bad. I'm on the cushion, okay. We're good. Everything is fine. And I'm pulling back away from Hinkie, so that's good. Been kind of riding at the top of the groove here this past few laps, and it's been working out for me. If you haven't been paying attention to the video. Ooh, close. So close to the wall. Uh-oh, hopping the cushion, okay. So only 10 out of 13 cars are going to finish, unless something happens, you know, these last, like, 10 laps.
10 laps to go.
To somebody. Man, I gotta be really careful on this, if I'm running this fucking high line, because one little slip up and I'm going in the wall. And I would probably lose my fifth place if that happened. Whoa, got a little drifty there. Actually, I think at this point with this line I'm running faster than Fazioli. Hear that, or he's just having that much trouble getting around Hinkie. Ooh. Flirting with that wall. The outside of Brandt, I guess. That worked out quite well, actually. So, name of the game here at the Speed Bowl is keep your speed as high as you can. I ran a 22 that lap. That was my first 22 in knows how many laps. And Hinkie is out. I'm gaining a lot of time on him. Yep, there he is. So that's four retirements now. And absolutely no pressure for me for losing fifth place, since I'm a lap ahead of the next sixth place car now. Well then, here comes Anderson. There goes Anderson.
There you go.
Two more laps. Shit, bad. Okay, we're good. Almost jumped the cushion again. And final lap go. Looks like Anderson is the leader. Maybe, I think. I don't fucking know. It's Anderson. Because it'd be either Anderson or Truett, considering Anderson's in front of Truett. Well, it took me to the final lap, but I finally hit the wall. There we go. Alright, yep, it was Anderson. He was actually finished a lap ahead of Truett. So, there you go. That was a race. I think he's gonna take ninth place. So, 9 out of the 13 drivers finished. Yay. I was only 5 laps behind that time. Winner. Good. I'm just looking at these stats. Alright, it's enough looking at the stats. Alright, let's look at these standings. So, Anderson won. 36-minute race, not bad. I was the only one that finished 5 laps down. And Kato retired at lap 19. 19, holy shit, alright. Well, that was that. Got my first top 5, so let's see what the headline says. And what sentence gets cut off. Oh, but first, oh my god. This prize money, yes. Got paid from all 3 of my sponsors. And just $72 for repairs, that would add the multipliers to that, $4,600. Fuck yeah. Alright. Now I can really upgrade this car. Comfortable. Ryan Burton crew member Thompson. Crew member Andrew Thompson. Where'd they get Andrew Thompson from? Random name generator. Alright, anyways. So, Anderson, Truett, Finger, Fazioli, me, Diamond, Bane, blah, blah, blah. And Ginter finished in 15th, so he finished 5th in the B main. Wow. That Bean and... Three out of the top 10 people in points finished... Actually, make that 4 out of the top 10 coming into this room. No, 3. I was looking at Kato for some reason as well. 3. Fucking didn't even make it out of the B main. What the shit. Alright. I made it to the top 10. Yay. With my first top 5. So now I just have to stay in the top 10. I have a 7-point advantage over Ginter. So that's not going to really last. 4 points behind Al. I don't know. It's gonna be tight for me to stay in the top 10, but I have 4 races to do it, so. Yeah. And a sponsorship offer that I can't fucking accept because, yeah, my sponsorships are full. Oh well. So, with that, after that pretty fucking successful race, stay tuned for more Dirt to Daytona, where we'll have a much faster car next time.